Hey guys, it's Biendeo. Welcome back to Strife. In the last part, we did a long sewer level, but now we are here for the fight of our life. So we'll head on, I guess. I got a little bit of things to talk about because I'm recording this on the day of the Nintendo Direct coming out. Like, I'm thinking, like, how far in the future am I uploading this? And probably, I don't know, a week, 2 weeks, maybe? We're on part 5, so we'll get that. But anyway, just before we head off, I'm gonna head over to... This guy sells ammo, right? Yeah. Can I have an ammo box? Okay. Just spend a bit of money, get a bit of ammo. Some metal armor. That's for good stuff. Some electric bolts. Okay. And this guy sells med kits, right? What? I swear I saved. Oh no. Oh, I just noticed the ammo satchel increases your bullet capacity. Alright. I also seem to have used all my money. Whoops. Oh well. Shouldn't be too bad. Because we got bullet capacity. It's all worth it. Yeah. Okay. So, anyway. You might be wondering, like, where's the castle? Well, it's here. This door. Finally open. I don't have the key, but, wow, that's really tempting. But dang, can't go in. So anyway, we're actually saving, and once we head towards here...
We have conflicting reports about the programmer's location. One says he's in a computer room, another...
Notice this front door. You can open it. There is a lot of, like, things going on, but particularly... Notice that you've got your fellow, rebel members sitting about. You don't have to... keep them alive, there's not really any, like, need. But, I recommend, you know, try to help them out. Also, you may notice, there's a new enemy. I recommend using napalm and blowing up all your teammates.
God, it's good to be on the offensive again. Give them hell, guys.
Also, I just demonstrated, you have napalm bursts as well as a napalm, like, or as well as the grenades as an alt fire on this weapon. And oh boy, is the napalm, like, so destructive. But it's not frequent. Yep. Gotta circle strafe that. Yeah! Pull that lever. Oh, hello, buddy. They're not actually too strong. Except for the rockets. The rockets are a bit annoying. But for the most part, you can handle them quite nicely. Giblets everywhere, it's beautiful. So yeah. Yeah, I think it's sometimes best just to ignore them. Look at these freaking rebel guys, they're everywhere. They're multiplying. And then plus, like, you enter the level and they've taken out, like, a lot of the enemies already. And, like, the very few enemies that do pop. Excuse me. Excuse me? I got this, guys. Don't worry. Ooh. One thing is that if you're on less health, you actually move a bit slower. That, you may want to look out for that. That sometimes could get a bit annoying. I think we managed to get almost all of them, if not all of them. I think we did, actually. Look at all these beautiful health kits. You can get yourself a mini missile launcher now. but it comes in handy a lot, especially because bullets, I was about to say bullets are not easy to come by, and I'm just picking up bullets left, right, and center. But like, look at this, I can hold 200 missiles! I think it's because I picked up the satchel, so I get double the ammo capacity, maybe that's why. Which means I wasted all my money. Whoops. Oh well. There's not a lot you spend your money on. I think this is probably the most appropriate part of the game to use it all. Look at this fancy door, man. But I don't really know where I'm going. I'm just kind of walking around in circles. That's the front door. I guess we just go via where the map is pointing, you know, try and get up here. Whoop, was that a teammate? Whoops.
This must be the long hallway. Either that or my sense of scale is shot to hell.
Did he just, like, shield block that missile? Man, it's Hexen all over again, you know? The guy who blocks the shields. So, anyway, I think I should talk just a little bit briefly about that Nintendo Direct, and more so, I think 2015 has been a pretty year in terms of games. Oop, the training facility. Oh. So yeah, so the training facility is another place. Alarm's going off right away. I'm right at home. Hello, Mr. Man.
Oh no, I'm not the real programmer. He's hiding. Continue past the guard training area. Very tough. If you survive, you might be able to talk to him. Or kill him.
You'd think I'd get tired of all this killing everyone stuff. But I know I'm gonna miss it when it's over.
You'll never find anything if you hang around here.
Okay. So, despite the fact that this guy is called the programmers, they're not the programmers. AIs are hard, man. AIs are hard to make. You need to do, like, special courses and majoring on that. If you wanna make good AIs. So it's amazing how this guy made all these murder machines. I mean, get that spider thing. Spider things are so, what the? Oh, it's Invisible Man. He's my favorite superhero. Pass pizza butt. The Armory Bakery. Grab key, yes. Hello. Look at that accuracy. I can't accurate. Oh, I already shot it, okay. Ooh, weapons. And actual ammo. Holy crap, how much ammo? Grenades. Look at all them grenades. Look at all this beautiful stuff.
Nope.
Oh. I've completely lost my bearings. Oh, this is just for the loot, for the mad loot. Alright. So I believe if we head down this hallway, oh gosh, I've completely lost. There we are, the guard training facility. I don't believe this is a required part, but it gets you a goodie if you're good at it. Is that an actual thing that will shoot me? Ah. And yes, it will shoot me. I knew it. There's this button to... Ooh. Flick the switch. Flick that switch. What did that do? Nothing. Hit this. What's that's doing? Do you know? I don't. It seems to be a room just kinda past here. I don't really know what's going on there, but alright. I'll take it. It's this switch and we'll figure it out. Oh! Oh, I'm standing in the poop. Get out of the poop. Oh, that's the doorway. Okay. Ah. I've come for your lunch money, everybody. Oh, jeez, spider. Ah. It takes real effort to chuck spiders at a man. Well, that staircase helps. Or doesn't. I can't hit it! And then it passes straight through it. Yeah, that works. Eh! I can't hold any more rockets. There's too many. Well, those do something. Maybe. Where does this portal go? Somewhere. What about this portal? The one I just went to. What about this portal? Aha, reveals the center. Oh! More turrets! The turrets are annoying, because... Okay. Where am I sitting? Bit of a weird ledge. Alright. Ah! Stop it with the rock... with the things! That was a solid hit, right there. I really should be using the flamethrower, but they haven't been like that good of an opportunity. There's really good opportunities, trust me. Wow. This is when the gun comes in handy. I don't need no vertical aiming. Know what I mean? What's the point of using the flamethrower if you got plenty of the ammo for it? Also, I swear I'm going around in circles right now. But I'm not. I'm going crazy. That's where I'm going. Wow, where is the anything? Where is the gun? I hear people over here, but like... this lift doesn't go anywhere, at least right now. Unless... that is a yeah, that's a door that's not open. So there's gotta be some kind of switch like somewhere in this maze. Check all the hallways. Oh, hello, Mr. Man. It might be based on kills, which is gonna be a bit of a nuisance. Follow the enemies, that's a sign of progress. There we go. This better be the place. What? Yeah, that did a thing. Oh no, it didn't do a thing!
Too bad.
Oh man, how far back did that just send me? All the way. Unless. Dang it. I swear I like walked past this spot before and I didn't spot it. This was so much like stuff. How about we flip that switch and then we just kind of watch what's happening down there, because that was not ideal. Yeah. I love the grenades. And that, I can't open the door, what? Oh, dang it. Oh, snap, yeah. When you die, it doesn't go all the way back. Jumping is not the best in shooters. Like, ever. Oh. There's pits everywhere. Whoa. Perhaps there's something back up here? Ah, nothing. What is... excuse me, good sir. Alright, that works, I guess. So I already flicked the switch, and it looks like there's stuff up there, but I can't get up there yet. Ooh. Well, hello. And will that open the other door? There's another door! Alright, where else was there a door? There was a door somewhere. Yeah, third door. I'll just save, because, I don't want to lose the progress.
Can you see the door?
So that's just a circle. So it's somewhere inside. There's that which I went up earlier. And then there's gotta be one more bit. The only other bit that there could be is this up here. Oh wow, it's open. And I'm still getting shot from across the way. At least I got this guy. Nope. There we go, that's the last door, right? Yeah. Oh, I can't even jump over this. Gotta walk back. That's alright. I think this part is actually completely optional. There we are. There we go. Bam! Achievement. That's how you know I'm awesome. Because I did that. And I managed to walk back into the trap. Even better. So I think I go in here and then I just, yeah, I'm here and I'm out, basically. I wonder why it's pointing me towards this guy. Wonder why. Oh well. We gotta keep going, though. We gotta keep going. Alright. So, was it actually down there? Couldn't have been. Gotta be somewhere else, like here, except I don't have the key. And now I'm in the water, getting shot by... not that guy. Whoops, sorry, I shot your friend. Whoa, jeez. Guess there's more action, more strife over here. Man's greatest enemy, the turrets, that hit from a bajillion, like, miles away. Ow! And this area is huge. This area is ginormous. There's a hospital in the area. There was a guy just going like, hey, what's up? What was your problem if the program comes up from this audience chamber? Alright. Hello. Walking about in a circle. You don't have the key. That's a problem. So the thing is that the game. Sorry, Mr. Man. I said sorry, like, sincerely. I was like, oh, sorry. Like I'm playing, like, Counter-Strike, all that stuff. Audience chamber, that's... is that it? Yeah. Yeah. Whoa! Make an entrance for yourself. Also, you see that guy right... you see that guy right behind him? I know, it's just like... it's just like, yeah, I'm ready for some fun, and it just like immediately chucks you into this kind of scenario. I'm nearly out of health as well, which is a bit of a woozy. Just go for the rockets. Why are you not dead? There we go. I need a silver key. Why? Nope. Why is this like side green and the side stone?
Nope.
There's a bit of cool stuff on the walls, I guess. Ooh. Oh gosh! Oh, that was close. Gonna raise it back up. Nice. Look at this bed! And again, same thing with the trap. I was just saying I need a silver key. I swear I'm supposed to have this open. Hold on for a moment. I think it's just that. Hello, Mr. Man.
You killed all the guards. Don't hurt me. I told him this was a dumb idea. The real programmer's in the keep. Here, take this key.
Oh, sweet.
Do I look like I wield ultimate power? The Order uses us all. Now go, I'm dead already.
Sure. Did he just give me the silver key? Yeah, that is a pickaxe. That is not a key. That is a pickaxe. Alright, this room's a bit weird because it's just kind of here on the side. All the enemies are just out the front. So, here we are. A secret! And I think there's also more secrets in like this area.
Nope.
Come on, there's a secret around here. I can smell it.
Nope.
There we go. Ooh. And last but not least, we can go into here. And I believe finicking on one of these. Maybe standing on it.
Nope.
Come on, there's something here. There it is. Ah! So yeah. Now you may be wondering, that is 9 out of the 16 secrets, and honestly, this game is not like too long, I'd say. It's not too long of a game. And I completely blanked out on the talking about games in 2015, didn't I? Because I died. Basically, I'd say most of 2015, the games just haven't been like really fantastic. I feel like people are gonna bring up the examples of, oh, but Halo 5 was good, but Call of Duty was good, but all that stuff, and I'm like, I think besides Call of Duty, everyone can safely say, like, yes, they're good, but they're just not as good as past games, and everything that has come out so far, pretty much, the only thing that hasn't come out this year is basically Just Cause 3 and, Star Wars Battlefront, and of course some good and some Nintendo titles, which are probably good, mainly because they've come out in Japan already. And I can safely say that, yeah, they're most likely gonna be good. Also, you may be wondering, like, we went to all these places and the programmer wasn't there. That's because he is up here, I think. Oh, there you go. Yeah, he's in here. Oh, I should have been paying attention. Oh gosh, what happened to you, friend? Come on, teammate. Yeah, teamwork. Except there's another one. Also, that napalm just single-handedly took him out. Beautiful napalm. Beautiful. So anyway, here we are, the programmer's keep. I think overall, yeah, like, 2015...
Weird. The weird get going.
Watch yourself.
I like this area because it's like confess your sins, and I'm like, sure. Perish, unbelievers! He just immediately sends these things after you. These flying things are actually like really weak. They do like 1 or 2 damage. Oh my gosh, where do they keep coming from? Hey, I defeated your goons. Nope. Nope. This guy's got a creepy-ish face. There you go. Ah! Those guys walking around, they're not like too strong, but... definitely there's a... there's a few, like new... I don't know what I'm talking about right now. I'm just like, oh, yeah, yeah. I haven't gotten used to commentary in a while. I'm sorry. What the heck? There's a snipe shot right there. Waiting to happen. Just shooting him. It's easy. So, yeah. I don't know about 2015. And honestly, like, all the releases that have been good have had some kind of controversy about them. People going like, oh, Fallout 4 just doesn't have, like, as much... stuff as Fallout 3, or a lot of really bad PC versions, the Arkham Knight stuff. I'm just gonna drop this one in here and completely miss everyone. Oh, come on. The one guy just left over. So yeah, so there's a lot of enemies here. So we're cutting it fine, especially because we're up to the point where we're starting to use our big health kits. Definitely I'm safe for ammo, but it's a bit weird hitting 4 for the rocket launcher as well compared to... oh gosh. Energy pod. Maybe I should use this. It's not as effective on robots as you'd want to, though. So yeah, I don't know. For 2015, I've actually, I kind of made a pact that I wouldn't buy any AAA games. At least nothing like new, because last thing I bought new was Watch Dogs, and yeah. Let's do a save, because this room looks a bit perilous. Man, yeah, what's going on? Get down the bottom. For the small health kits, sweet. Did I just use the big health kits already? What? Alright. Oh boy. Actually no, I'll just use this. I'm not tall enough. I gotta get out of the room. And he's just gonna be waiting right there. Ah! Gotta wreck them. So many of them, you know? Yeah, so... I've been holding off, but even then, I don't feel like I'm missing out on really anything, at least this year. Because they're all... not as good as past games. And so it's just encouraging me to buy the past games. I don't believe... These, by the way, they're not respawning. They're just teleporting in from an external place. Fit them tight in a room. This area, by the way, is big, and there's a lot of, like, corners to get the health and stuff. Oh, crap. Jeez. Ah! Gosh! Oh, crap. Don't stand right next to your grenade! Never a good idea. So I don't know. Definitely with this Nintendo Direct, I feel like there's a bit of good stuff Nintendo's releasing by the end of the year, but not a ton. Also, did the auto health not kick in? How far back did I save? Oh, back here. How about? Nah, it's not worth it. There's another one, isn't there? There he is. I don't think the auto healing kicks in for the big health kits. I think I have to manually be using them. That's even worse. Just walk around and activate everything. These enemies are a pain, especially because, remember when I said when you're on lower health, you move slower? Yep. Nice. Ow. That wasn't nice. Apologize, sir. Apologize. I don't know, what do you guys think about this year in games? I think, like... I don't really have a lot to say, because... Things that I agree with... things have been said by a ton of other people, and definitely, yeah, the case holds. I just think that overall, I don't want to buy these games because I don't want to encourage a lot of things to.
Go ahead.
Oh no! When was the last time I saved? Ah, it's back here. Ah. Yeah, I don't want to buy a lot of these AAA games because I don't want to encourage developers to. Keep doing some of the really annoying stuff, like releasing games that don't run on a lot of hardware that people, like, have. I understand with maybe your Fallout 4, it's like, sure, if you're hard-coding it to 60 FPS, the majority of people, like, playing the game at least right now, sure, they're not gonna notice. But some people are noticing it right now, and it's definitely going to be noticeable in the future when everyone's going to be using higher frame rate monitors. And wow, did I... Yeah, that just used all the health kits. Cool. Kaboom! Oh, jeez, that's why I'm dying. May as well use this. And this. This gives a targeting reticule, by the way. And use an environmental suit. This gives a targeting reticule, which actually, I believe, gives you full accuracy while it's active. Which is kind of neat. They seem to be able to hit me, despite the fact that they don't know where I am. This Doom logic for you. I'm gonna just stick with the rocket launcher. The crosshair is pretty, like, tacky big, though. I believe once you get to a certain, like, killed things, then you finally can go up here, where this guy pops up, and he's like, ah! Also, he kills you in one go. Did I save just before? Yeah. Now, you need to get up these steps if you want to get a secret. There we go. Easy. Some health kits. Always good. Bit of ammo. Oops. I think you gotta use one of these pillars in the back. There we go. Nice. So yeah. Anyway, I think we've gone long enough. The lightning's a bit annoying, I'll tell you that, because it's a one-hit kill basically, or it deals at least buttloads of damage. So we're just gonna flamethrow this guy. And yeah, this is one of the first bosses in the game. The bosses speed up definitely. I feel like we're halfway through the game like already. It's not that long of a game, to be honest. But there's a bit of neat stuff to show. The flamethrower is not the most accurate thing. But it seems to be doing its job quite nicely. I think I shouldn't be using the flamethrower. I think we should be using the napalm. And dying.
All right, I'm not complaining, but...
Stop complaining! That killed him, by the way. Just hitting him with the napalm a few times. Hello!
Good. You're conscious again. When you grab that item the programmer dropped, you let loose some terrible secrets.
Okay.
Fragments assembled from the programmer's files tell us that the Order is worshipping an intelligent weapon. They call it the Sigil.
The Sigil?
The piece you touched and recovered is one of five. It wields power drawn from the user's own life force. While you live, you control its power. The shock which knocked you out was the Sigil piece tuning itself to you, your pulse, and brainwaves. You can wield it, but at a cost. It will drain you dry. One piece constitutes awesome power. Possession of all five pieces would be devastating and would give the user total control of the planet. We have no idea where this weapon came from, but we must find out. You have wrested one from the Order, but we must have all five.
Okay.
We've reached the limits of my knowledge. Seek out the Oracle and ask it for help. Here's your goal. Go visit the medic and the weapons trainer, and then move out.
Alright. So anyway!
The Oracle Temple is in the borderland, on the outskirts of town.
Sure. A lot of the targeting rack was still there on the screen, like, why? Alright. Anyway, with that, I'm gonna end the part off here. I'll see you kids next time!